According to statistics, Uganda imports pharmaceuticals worth 1 trillion shillings annually, despite the fact that the country has medical experts who have the knowledge to manufacture different medicines locally. It's against this background that the government, with support of the investors, is set to build a drug manufacturing plant in the country. This will be located in Nakasongola district. They are convinced that the local manufacturing of medicines will reduce prices as well as ensuring their availability in the country.
We therefore call the foreign exhibitors to work towards investing a local manufacturing here in Uganda. This will transform the pharmaceutical sector and enable it to be more responsive to the needs of the Ugandan people.
The Assistant Commissioner of Health Services, Pharmaceutical Supply Chain and Logistics, Dr. Martha Grace Ajilong, noted that they are to intensify the tracking of the drugs right from the manufacturers up to the users, and this will help to weed out fake drugs.
Minister of Health, we are going to emphasize what we call GS1 coding for all the manufacturers. That is what we are now where we are heading, so that we have all the commodities that are manufactured have codes right from the manufacturer up to the user, so that it helps us to track these commodities.
The development comes ahead of the third edition of Uganda's largest pharma, medical and healthcare international exhibition, which will run from 22nd up to 24th next week in Kampala at Umma Showground. This event will be hosting medical professionals, pharmacies, hospitals, health organizations, importers and exporters, decision makers and medical practitioners of the East Africa region.
Exhibition to the professionals is a must attend, because we're going to be dealing with aspects of technology and equipment.
In this event that is going to run between the 22nd and 24th, we will be showcasing some of the services that we are able to offer locally, the technologies that are available at our disposal locally, and we'll also be privileged to interact with several other exhibitors from across the globe to be able to learn from them.
Story compiled by Juliet Namoya for the news.